Project 2, School Habitat Garden, Question Answers from Grade 7, Subject Vocational Education, Book Kaushal Bodh, Table 2.1, Page 31, Animals that you want or not want in the school habitat garden. We would like these animals in our habitat garden. First, butterflies, second, sunbirds, third, sparrows, fourth, squirrels, fifth, dragonflies. We would not like these animals in our habitat garden. First, mosquitoes, second, snakes, third, rats, fourth, monkeys, fifth, wasps. Page 31. Which of the animals identified in the surrounding of the school are likely to be attracted to our school habitat garden? Answer: animals like butterflies, sunbirds, sparrows, squirrels, ants, and dragonflies can be attracted to our school habitat garden if we provide food, water, shelter, and space for them. Second, how can we prevent the entry of animals we do not want in the school habitat garden? Answer: we can prevent unwanted animals like snakes or mosquitoes by avoiding stagnant water, keeping the garden clean, and not leaving piles of wood or trash where they can hide. Page 32. Question 3. Where should the habitat garden be developed? Answer: the garden should be developed in a quiet and open space in the school, like a corner of the playground or terrace where sunlight is available and there is less human disturbance. Table 2.2, page 32. Needs of animals we would like in our habitat garden. Name of animals: butterfly. Food they usually eat: nectar, rotting fruit. How to make provision for water and food: shallow dishes with sugar water or moist soil. Shelter they need: trees, bushes, rocks. Space they need: open sunny areas. Any other example: specific plants, flowers, etc. to attract them: marigold, hibiscus, lantana. Next, sunbird. Food they usually eat: nectar, insects. How to make provision for water and food: hanging feeders with sugar water, flowering plants. Shelter they need: shrubs, small trees. Space they need: medium open space. Any other: hibiscus, bottle brush flowers. Next, house sparrow. Food they usually eat: seeds, grains, insects. How to make provision for water and food: bowls of water, grains in feeders. Shelter they need: bushes, rooftops. Space they need: moderate space. Any other: seed plants, millet. Next, squirrel. Food they usually eat: nuts, fruits, seeds. How to make provision for water and food: bowls of water under trees. Shelter they need: tree hollows, branches. Space they need: trees with canopy. Any other: guava tree, mango tree. Next, dragonfly. Food they usually eat: small insects. How to make provision for water and food: water from ponds or puddles. Shelter they need: around water bodies, plants. Space they needs small wetlands. Any other: wet corner of garden, pond. Next, ants. Food they usually eat: sugar, dead insects. How to make provision for water and food: water droplets on plants. Shelter they need: soil under stones. Space they need: small colonies. Any other: compost pile, small stones. So friends, you can note these down. Next, table 2.3, preventing animals from the habitat garden. Name of the animals: mosquitoes. Why do we not want them in our garden? Spread diseases like dengue and malaria. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Avoid stagnant water. Next, snakes. Why do we not want them in our garden? Dangerous and can scare students. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Keep area clean, remove hiding spots. Next, rats. Why do we want them in our garden? Damage plants and carry disease. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Seal food sources, no food litter. Next, monkeys. Why do we not want them in our garden? Mischievous and damaging. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Avoid fruits left out. Avoid open food. Next, wasps. Why do we not want them in our garden? Aggressive, can sting. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Avoid sugary liquids in open. Next, stray dogs. Why do we not want them in our garden? May destroy garden area. What can we do to prevent them from entering the habitat garden? Fencing and keep the garden area closed. So friends, you can also note this down. Now let's move forward. Table 2.4, page 34. Observations of habitat and behavior of animals. Description of habitat. Animals. First, butterfly. Space. Needs sunlight. Water. Sips from moist soil. Food. Nectar. Shelter. Trees. Plants. Anything else. Likes quiet areas. Next, sunbird. Space. Branches. Water. Sips from dripping tap. Food, nectar, insects, shelter, bushes, anything else, very active and quick. Next, ants, space, small holes, water, dew or water drops, food, sugar, insects, shelter, under stones, anything else, live in colonies. Next, beetles, space, under leaves, water, moist compost, food, dead plant matter, shelter, rotting logs, anything else, found after rain. Next, sparrow, space, ledges, water, from bowls or puddles, food, grains, seeds, shelter, bushes, roof, anything else, moves in groups. Next, lizard, space, climbs walls, water, licks dew, food, insects, shelter, under stones, anything else, basks in sun. So friends, you can note it down. Now let's move forward. Page 37. Question 1. Where will you make the habitat garden? Example, any open unutilized space on the school grounds or a balcony terrace. Answer. We will make the habitat garden in an unused corner of the school ground or on the school terrace using pots and containers if ground space is not available. Question 2. How much sunlight does the space receive during the day? Answer. The selected area receives good sunlight for 5 to 6 hours. Some parts have light shade due to nearby trees, which is also helpful for shelter. Question 3. What specific elements do animals need to be attracted to your habitat garden? Consider features like flowering plants, rocks in sunny areas, plants that can break the wind for butterflies, water collecting under a garden tap, etc. Answer. Animals need flowering plants, clean water in shallow containers, flat rocks for basking, damp mud for puddling, and trees or bushes to rest or hide. These elements make the garden friendly for birds, butterflies, and small animals. Page 38, question 4. Do any of the above already exist in the school? If yes, what are they? Answer. Yes. Our school already has some trees, bushes, and a tap near the garden area that sometimes leaks water. These will help attract birds and insects. Question 5. Are there any other aspects that need to be covered? Answer. Yes. We need to build bird feeders, butterfly puddling spots, and insect shelters. We also need to create a proper walking path to avoid disturbing animals. Question 6. What kind of plants will need to be planted to attract animals, birds, and insects to your habitat garden? Answer. We will plant seasonal flowering plants like marigold, hibiscus, sunflower, and herbs like tulsi and mint. These attract butterflies, bees, and birds. Question 7. How will you make sure you do not disturb animals while watering and weeding your garden? Answer. We will create walkways using sand or bricks so that we don't step on plants or disturb animals. We will do watering gently in the morning when animals are less active. Page 44, Table 2.6, Observation records of visitors to the habitat garden. Insects, first butterfly, date 12 May, second dragonfly, date 13 May, third ants, date 13 May, fourth, beetles, Date 14th May, 5th spiders, date 15th May, 6th grasshopper, date 15 May. Remarks: number observed 15 plus, stage of insect, adults mostly. Where did you observe it? Near plants, compost and soil. Insects activity, feeding, building shelters, mud puddling. Next birds: first sunbird, date 12 May, second sparrow, date 13 May, third dove, date 14 May. Remarks: number observed 10. Where did you observe it? Near flowering plants and feeders. Bird activity, feeding, bathing, singing. Next small mammals: first squirrel, date 12 May, next mouse, date 13 May, next bat, date 14 May. Number observed 5. Where did you observe it? Trees, compost pile, animal activity, feeding, hiding, resting. So friend, you can note it down and you can also change the dates according to you. Okay, now let's move forward. Page 45, table 2.7, maintenance schedule for the habitat garden. Schedule for second week of the month of July. Task: watering of plants. Responsibility: Ravi and team. Planned date for the activity: every day. Date: activity was performed on as per schedule. Remarks: completed regularly. So friends, you can change name of students according to you. These are just the examples. Next, filling of watering and bathing containers. Responsibility: Priya and team. Planned date for the activity: every day. Date: activity was performed on as per schedule. Remarks: filled in morning. Next, feed in the bird feeder. Responsibility: Anaya. Planned date for the activity: once in a week. Date: activity was performed on 8 July. Remarks: used grains and seeds. Next, weeding. Responsibility: Arjun. Planned date for the activity: once in a month. Date: activity was performed on 10 July. Remarks: removed unwanted grass. Next, cleaning of garden. Responsibility: all team members. Planned date for the activity: every day. Date: activity was performed on ongoing. Remarks: composting leaves. Next, composting of agro waste. Responsibility: Karthik and Simran. Planned date for the activity: every day. Date: activity was performed on ongoing. Remarks: used in plant beds. Page 46. What did I learn from others? Question 1. What are the three most fascinating things you have discovered? Answer: first, butterflies drink water from wet soil, mud puddling. Second, birds take dust baths to clean their feathers. Third, fireflies glow to communicate but are disappearing due to light pollution. Question 2. What key insights did you gain from observing and discussing about the living beings and their habitat? Answer: I understood that all animals need food, water, shelter, and space. If we protect their habitat, they help us in return, like birds controlling insects and butterflies helping in pollination. Next, think and answer. Question 1. What did you enjoy doing? Answer: I enjoyed planting new flowers, creating the butterfly feeder, and watching birds and insects come to the garden. Question 2. What were the challenges you faced? Answer: we faced problems like watering the garden daily, avoiding mosquitoes, and keeping the place clean. Question 3. What will you do differently next time? Answer: next time I will plan better to use water wisely, prepare a stronger fence, and include more shade-loving plants. Question 4. According to you, what is the importance of the habitat garden? Answer: it helps small animals and insects find a safe home, improves biodiversity, and teaches us to care for the environment. Question 5. How do you plan to maintain the habitat garden after completion of project activities? Answer: we will create a weekly schedule where each team member will take care of watering, cleaning, feeding, and checking plant health regularly. Last question, identify few examples of jobs related to the work you just did. Answers: some related jobs are naturalist, observes animals and nature. Next, conservationist, works to protect animals and forest. Next, entomologist, studies insects. Next, zoologist, studies animals. Next, botanist, studies plants. Next, forest officer, protects wildlife in forest. Next, environmentalist, works to protect the earth. So friends, we have completed all the question answers from Project 2, School Habitat Garden. I hope this video helps students a lot. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also, subscribe to my channel for more such videos. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.